What is up, YouTube gods and goddesses? It's your boy Mike from Duck Walk Professional Services, and today we're out here throwing some mushroom soil down and throwing some seed down for the boy over here. They got some, they're used to look like that, just basically bare soil. We're throwing some mushroom down, trying to get them to have a nice looking lush lawn back here. Basically, I recommend using seed. I just use this container because I like the way it sprinkles out like that. But we like using mushroom soil a lot better than eco soil because there's a lot less weeds in it. It is more expensive, but it's a better organic material than just regular topsoil. So just use it, sprinkle little seeds down for the boy. Got pretty much the whole dump truck unloaded. We got a little bit of mushroom soil left in there for the next planting job, and we got about 6 knockouts in there. So that's like 150 bucks in roses just right there. Part of living the dream in Brigantine is working right across the street when they got the farmer's market going on. So we're gonna hit this organic joint and get something to drink. Yo, Jimmy, you got to give yourself some better credit. It's better than a great novel, dude.
What is it? It's an amazing novel. Yeah,
you can get a better adjective than that in there. You're the author. Boys, we got this next job going on here. We got this 5-gallon crepe myrtle plant that we're gonna put in the middle of this grass for these people, and it'll grow. The only problem is we got some power lines up there, so we're gonna position a little bit and get it worked out for the boys. Okay, first step when planting a 25-gallon Muscovy crepe myrtle. Wow, $342. First step is determine the location you want it, then dig a hole. And then this is the next type of tree we are gonna be planting here. I believe this is a willow, a type of willow tree sold from Joe's Garden Center on the White Horse Pike. And it's basically the same type of tree that the neighbors have over here, and it's withstood a lot of salt water and everything else. So we're claiming this is a good tree to plant in this spot, in this position, since we're right across the bay right here and we do get salt water intrusion. Okay, boys, you get the plant, the hole dug. You want to dig it twice as big as the pot, so you can have plenty of room for the roots in the tree to grow. And then we're gonna backfill. We're using this good mushroom soil, pretty much organic matter for the tree. All right, guys, we got this tree planted here. It's looking nice and crispy. We got it even with that weeping willow tree at the neighbor's property over there, and we got it lined up with the crepe myrtle that we planted earlier over there. So all in all, I'm claiming this was a successful tree mission. Get it done, customers are happy. I'm not a big fan of putting trees in the middle of yards, but you know, so you got to do what the customer, you know, wants sometimes.
Go buy a bunch of stuff. Am I taking a picture?
No,
what are you doing?
So what were you claiming about it?
Claiming what?
About this flea market.
Are you making a movie?
Does it matter?
I want to sell stuff. I don't care what I sell, I want to sell stuff. And that's all. Cut, film.
All right, boys, we're out here. We got a heavy mission to accomplish right now. We got the box truck out here, and we're going to be rolling all the mob porters treasure up in here so that we can go to the Summers Point volunteer firefighters flea market tomorrow. All right, boys, we're set for a heavy mission right now. We got the box truck sitting out here, and it's empty right now, and we're about to fill it up with all the treasures from the mob porter's house, because we're going to the flea market in Pleasantville at the volunteer firefighters on Bethel Road. So come check the boys out. We'll have a full truck, and watch the, you know, this video to see how the dream lives on for the boy. All right, you come into the shop, and there's the pisser. And here is the treasure. So it's like almost too heavy of a situation to deal with. It's like, look at all this shit all in here. All has, like, damn. Maybe I should have put this away a little bit better. But I got a couple wheelbarrows. Just start humping it out. This mission seems like it's almost too heavy. That's why we need a Coors Light to accompany the boy. Came across these two in the pile, the hoard, and I'm claiming these as keep life. I might go into window washing business like Keith Kelfis of the Landscape Employee Trap. Check them out. And this is a shout out to Brother Murph. We got these, we got like a whole box of these scrubbers, man. You can wash your balls for days, boy. Alright, this is especially for B Colt right there. I got you two handles. I think you'd like those plastic ones better. If you want the wooden one, let the god know. I'll hook you up. But and then I'll throw in a couple mop heads there for you. But if you could ever wonder why I would want to sell all this mess for $1 instead of $2, it's because right now it's such a problem to deal with that I would rather just burn it all. I think I would get like more satisfaction of having a big ass bonfire and throwing this all in the fire and not having to see it again than I would making like any more money than I already have. So that's, if you could understand where I'm coming from with that, it's, this stuff's gotta go, boys. It's too crazy. It's a problem to deal with it, but it's also a blessing. I mean, you get all this free inventory, but it's like, How are you supposed to deal with this shit? It's like it's almost too much to deal with. So, all the boys out there getting their hustle on, keep working hard. Know that the mop god feels your struggle. It is hard to deal with at times, but we just got to push forward. Keep going until the next coldie for the boys. All right, B Colt, look, I got your stash here. You got a bunch of mops there. And two different handles for the boy. All right, so you're gonna be mopping for the rest of your life, thinking about the mop god every time you do it. All right, boys, you can see we got the mop hoard cleaned out for right now. We'll see what happens tomorrow. If it'll stay this way, or if the hoard will come back to its rightful owner. Wouldn't have been able to do the job without the Hangover Pretzel Company. I like the cinnamon flavor. They make some hot and some lemon pepper, but that's my go-to. Stop there today on the dream journey. And I definitely couldn't have done it without a couple cold CLs. And we got this mop hoard, this treasure trove all loaded up. Gonna see what happens tomorrow. It's for the boys. I do what?
Check the mailbox.
Why would I do that?
I don't know. No.
Did you?
I just did now, and there's nothing in there.
Well, then I didn't check it. No.
Okay.
So no mail.
No mail.
Did somebody steal it?
I don't think so.
No. That's the claim.
That's the claim.
Okay.
All right. You leaving now?
Getting ready to.
Okay. Gonna do the screen, that glass door screen.
Put
the
right
screen
now?
Yeah.
All right then, if I must have to do it right now.
Can I lock this?
Then how am I gonna get up there?
Okay. That door. What do you want? This door or that door?
Both of them.
Make a choice.
I want both open.
All right, as long as you lock this. What's the matter with that?
Whenever you're at Nan's house, the duty's never done. So she wants me to put up a screen door, her summer screen door now. And also I had to put on the sprinklers for the garden back here. So the job never ends for the mop guy.
You see what we got going on back here. That's a tree that I saved, a southern magnolia that I planted for a customer, and he was claiming that it wasn't any good, but there you go, I took care of it. That's the problem was, is that he didn't love it, and he didn't take care of it like I did, so you can see how it's blooming there. And then what we got going on over here is Nan's vegetable garden. She loves planting the tomatoes like so close together, so in the summertime, it'll be a fucking jungle back here. Wait till your boys see it. We got tomatoes for days back here. It'll be a jungle full of tomatoes.
When you come into Nan's house and she asks you to do a couple more errands, you better know you're going to be drinking a couple more CLs. Right, Nan?
A wonderful family.
Alright boys, we almost got a successful double mission here. We got Nan's pane here of glass that we took out, and then we transplanted it for Nan's screen door here so she can have the breeze come in from the top level. So I'm claiming if Nan comes down with the CL for me, then it was for the boys. If not, then it wasn't. And it doesn't look like she has a CL, does she, boys? No.
Okay. Check out Miss Judy out there working that broom. That's a good wife right there, boys.
Mm-hmm. All right, boys. Naturally, Nan always has another project for you. She says she's tired of looking at this. It doesn't really do any purpose, so we're going to see if the boys can remove that for her. It's a couple Phillips screws, so we'll see how this goes. Alright boys, the claim is done, the piece is removed, and it didn't take a drill, it just took a little bit of brute force for the boys. So what kind of flower is that called?
Isn't it cute?
It's weird, it looks like a succulent.
It's an annual hanging basket.
Yeah, obviously. Where's Rob's? Bob's.
Bob's.
No, yeah, okay. Because we know Joe. We were dealing with Joe today. He's a really good guy.
Yesterday
before. All right, all you gods out there, we're just leaving Nan's house. What a glorious day it is, helping Nan out, getting the hoard, the mop god's hoard out, trying to sell it. If not, we're gonna burn it. So if not, it was a good day. We drank a couple coldies. Had some good pretzels from Hangover Pretzel Company. All in all, I'm claiming it was a successful day. Now the journey home, the hard part.
Kids get sucked into the phone like this boy has. He does not even know that I'm talking about him right now. He has his face buried in the phone. Zebra! You think that's funny to be buried in the phone like that? What about the world? And what about Uncle Mike?
Ew.
Don't you want to be a part of me?
You.
Huh?
I will be part of Dad.